Hello, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I start a tutorial and I will explain you how to do a image classifier and do a fine tuning with your own data. I'm gonna use a vision transforming as a foundation model, and we will personalize or fine tune the model with a data set that I created for a specific project. Well, I got it from internet. It's a data set which contain images which can be classified as non-safe for work. It's a data set with 5 different classes. The purpose is to identify content on a data lake which is not non-suitable or non-safe for work, as porno or hentai or sexy images that some people can be browsing in internet and keeping in data lakes, and this is in some cases breaching the law. And then to do this, and as I said, I'm using as a foundation model, a pre-trained model. We will do transfer learning. We are going to use this a model which is pre-trained with the ImageNet dataset, which are 14 million images and 28,843 classes. We will use this model as a feature extractor and as a foundation create our final model. The model has an architecture of the vision transformer, and essentially the model is having you need to do some transformation in order to adapt the images to the input of the neural network. And I will explain this in the future in the other parts of this tutorial. But essentially what we do with the image is to make a kind of transformation to adapt the size and the non-flat the image into a vector, a long vector, which is being the input of the image. You can go and take a look to the papers that are stated in this page and see what is the full details of the architecture that is being used for this model. Let's go to the notebook. I will be posting these notebooks in the description of this video later in Facebook. And then I'm using a Google Colab Pro. In this case, I'm not going to use a GPU. In other parts of the tutorial, we will use the GPU one. So we install the libraries we need. I access the drive. I'm using for reporting and to keep all the artifacts and history of the experiments weight and bias API. If you are familiar with TensorFlow, familiar with MLflow, you will find weight and bias pretty similar. Is the concept is really similar to MLflow. Later on, I will give you a short introduction of this technology. So I log in on 1DB just to log and to keep track of everything I'm doing in these experiments in this site. No, you can take a look here. Yes. Okay. So later on, during the tutorial, I will be explaining you how to use these dashboards. The paths to my data, we had 28,000 images split in 3 different data sets. Here are the folders, train, validation and test. 5 different classes, drawings, hentai, neutral, porn and sexy. The data set is fully balanced, we had the same number of the pictures per class, and regardless the data set, so it's correctly balanced. Probably there is some kind of quality issues, and some pictures are misclassified, but well, for the time being, in the previous experiments I'm running, it was not a problem. Here we imported the libraries we need. We create a class label object. This is a class from dataset, Hugging Face datasets. You can have some reference here about this dataset class in Hugging Face. A class label is a specific class which help you to identify, to transfer, to translate categories to labels and vice versa. Here we go through the data. As I said, we had organized the data in three different folders: train, validation, and test. These folders contains as well five different folders, one per category, and inside the folders there are the images. So in this part of the code, I will go through the path, and I will be creating three lists. One contains a pillow object, the image itself, the other one the path in is a string, and then on the label, which is a category from 0 to 4, which represent the label of the image. I'm creating these labels just looking at the folder where the image is, where is the image. So I run this code. It's gonna take some minutes. So I will be back when this is done. Hi. Well, the process is done. We had already created the train, test, and validation datasets. So here, just following with the process, we create a dictionary with the attributes, the features that had our dataset. We are going to have three attributes where we plug the list of the components that we defined before. So image is the list of the pillow objects. Image path is a list of the strings which just point to the location of the images, and labels integer from 0 to 4, representing the category of the class. Then on, we use the class dataset from Hugging Face and the method from dictionary. On the mapping, you just place the dictionary defined before, and you use features with a feature object, and then define the data types of the attributes that you are going to upload into the HF dictionary. So labels is going to be a integer value, an integer, image and string, and the image attributes and image from Hugging Face. Just a small note here: dataset contains a class image, and also pillow contain a class image. That's why here I had to rename from image to image to no. To not override the class image of datasets. Then on, I cast the column labels to the class label defined here. That will allow me later on to transform from key to category and vice versa. And then I shuffle the datasets, just because here I'm following a sequential loading, and then the images are sorted sequentially, and then we need some kind of entropy in order to train correctly the neural network. Same process for validation dataset, and same process for test dataset. Here we create a dataset dictionary. If you are going to push your dataset to Hugging Face, you need to create this object, and it's just a dictionary of the dataset objects. And as you can see here, we had 18,000 images for training, 5,000 images for test, and for validation, and 5,000 images for test. That is, I'm going to use in a final validation, it's acting as a whole dataset, and the validation dataset is going to be used during the training phase. The feature of the one of the datasets is, you can see here, we had the image is a image object, image paths is a string, and labels is a class label. So now we just took an example, just we plotted. As you can see, the image is a pillow GPG, size 600, 887, image size, we just here check the feature labels, class labels, and this with this method, a label you transform essentially from integer to string. It's just taking what we had on the example in labels is a drawing. We had a number, if I don't remember, round 3. Let's check it out. What we have here. And then essentially just transforming the integer to the label. And now we are going to serialize two digs. We just point to the digs. We use the method save to digs. We just get the path and we use a name. This is an arrow format. And the purpose is later on use these files in posterior phases of this tutorial, because it's not you will have to go through the process again. And finally here I just finished the 1DB login. In this part of the tutorial we can basically upload the same files to weight and bias. I didn't do it, but yeah, it's a matter to just lock these files and have a version of the file into weight and bias. As these files are relatively bleak, I prefer to keep it in local and not spend the resources in weight and bias. So it's gonna take a while. I will pause here this, and then we will continue once it's done, just to review the files on the digs. So the process finish. Let's take a look to the digs. As we had here, the content, as I said, is an arrow file. Here's the metadata. Here we had the train. Train obviously is bigger, so we had the multiple chunks of the arrow table, and here the validation dataset. Well, that's all. If you like the content, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you. We see you later.